Welcome, my name is Janine, and in this video, we're going to explore the object known as Messier 31, also more commonly known as the Andromeda Galaxy. Andromeda Galaxy is really large. It's 200,000 light years in diameter, which is twice the size of our own Milky Way galaxy. And it's one of the objects in the autumn sky, if you're living in the northern hemisphere, in which you can see with the naked eye. It is estimated to be 2.5 million light years away. So let's take a closer look on how to find this and some of the characteristics of this galaxy. Here we have a star map showing the constellation of Andromeda and some of the celestial objects that are seated in the boundaries of this constellation. If you want to know how to find Andromeda, go see that video. In this video, we're going to focus on the Andromeda Galaxy and some of its unique characteristics. But keep in mind that the Andromeda Galaxy is not the only celestial objects within the boundaries of Andromeda. We have the Snowball Nebula, which is a planetary nebula. Looks very beautiful right here. There's also satellite galaxies that are going around the Andromeda Galaxy. Here is another one called NGC 891, another edge-on spiral galaxy that we can see. And then NGC 752 is an open star cluster. So how can you find Andromeda Galaxy? Let's look at this photo because there's quite a few constellations we can see here. Right here, this is Cassiopeia. So you can use this little arrow part of Cassiopeia to guide you down towards Andromeda, and can you find that fuzzy patch of light? So if we were to point everything out here, this is Cassiopeia. Use that little arrow to aim you down towards Andromeda Galaxy, and then here is Andromeda. So for this video, we're going to focus on the Andromeda Galaxy, which is also called Messier Object 31. It's classified as a barred spiral galaxy that's estimated to be 2.5 million light years away, and there is no shortage of information on this galaxy because it's a favorite for amateur astronomers to photograph, or astrophotographers to photograph, because it's one of those objects that you can clearly find in the night sky. But since it's one of the closer galaxies towards our own Milky Way galaxy, it's one that is studied a lot by astronomers. It also has these satellite galaxies. There's a total of 15 satellite galaxies around Andromeda, but the ones I want to bring your attention to are right here. This is Messier 32. It's identified as an elliptical satellite galaxy. And then right down here is Messier 110. This is a dwarf elliptical galaxy. So these satellite galaxies, much like the satellite galaxies of the Milky Way, they have older, more gas, poor stars that can be seen within those galaxies. And then here is another great image taken by David Coughlin. He's an astrophotographer in the UK. And you can see the beautiful Andromeda Galaxy right here. Keep in mind, it's 200,000 light years across. That's twice the size of our own Milky Way galaxy. And you can see some of the satellite galaxies right there. And keep in mind that the Milky Way has its own satellite galaxies, as well as the Andromeda galaxies. And eventually, these two, the Milky Way and Andromeda, are on a collision course, and they will collide in 4.5 billion years. So it's not gonna happen for a pretty long time. But as I said earlier, Andromeda is one of those galaxies that is highly studied. So here is a picture of this galaxy in ultraviolet light. And this just allows you to see different features. You can see the core of the galaxy right here, and then you can see the spiral arms coming out from the center as well. You can see barred arms over here. And if we take a look at the Andromeda Galaxy in infrared, you see similar features, but it also shows you where the heat of the galaxy is as well. So right within the arms. And the arms are where the youngest stars of a galaxy are located. So they're young, blue, and hot. This is just another version of the Andromeda Galaxy in infrared light taken by NASA's Galaxy Evolution Explorer. And this mosaic covers an equivalent to 100 full moons. So a lot of data has been collected on the Andromeda Galaxy. And what's interesting enough is one of the most famous galaxy pictures that we have of Andromeda is this one taken by the Hubble Space Telescope. And I will leave the link for this photo in the description down below. But you can scroll in and zoom into this photo and see a great amount of detail. This picture was taken over the course of 3 years, and the total exposure time is 16.1 days. So it took the Hubble certain periods from 2010 to 2013 to put this whole mosaic together, and it was a total of 394 hours. So this is a really beautiful galaxy to just view, and we have a lot of data on it. So try to explore some of those resources that I put in the link below in the video description, just to learn and explore more about Andromeda. As I said earlier, there is a collision that will happen in 4 billion years. So here you have the Milky Way. The Sun is about 2/3 of the way out from the center of the Milky Way. And then you have the Triangulum Galaxy, which is one galaxy that you can find close by in the sky to Andromeda. If you want to learn more about that, go see that video. But M33 is the Triangulum Galaxy, and M31 is the Andromeda Galaxy, and in 4 billion years, they will collide. Here is one more photo I have for you that shows how you can find two of these galaxies. So this is a picture of Andromeda, and unfortunately, some of the constellation is being hidden by this telescope. This is the very large telescope that shows the Chilean sky. It's very gorgeous. And you can see the Andromeda Galaxy right here. This is the Triangulum Galaxy. And if you find Andromeda and draw a line through the beta star of Andromeda, that's where Triangulum is. So these are two galaxies that are on a collision course with our own Milky Way galaxy. We've come to the end of our video about Andromeda Galaxy, and I hope you learned some strategies on how to find this galaxy, as well as some cool facts and resources about it. Remember that Andromeda Galaxy is considered to be the jewel of the autumn sky because it's one of the points in the sky that you can see with the unaided eye, and it has the oldest light you'll ever see with the unaided eye. It takes 2.5 million light years to see light from the Andromeda Galaxy, and it takes that long for it to reach Earth. So if you are trying to find the Andromeda Galaxy, this is the star pattern that you're most likely to see, kind of a curved V-like shape. You start right here at the head of Andromeda, count 1, 2, 3, then move over 1, 2, 3. So that's the strategy I learned on how to find this constellation. I wish you luck trying to find the Andromeda Galaxy. It's a really beautiful object to see, not only with the unaided eye, but if you have the privilege to be able to see it in a telescope, it really is such a beautiful sight. Remember, it takes time, patience, and practice to find these objects in the sky. I wish you luck and keep looking up. I'd like to send a huge thank you and shout out to David Coughlin for allowing me to use his amazing photos for this video. Be sure to check him out on Twitter.